for the living to represent the dead, especially the literary deceased. But allow me to walk the border between the two spheres of existence. Allow me to let ghosts talk through my mouth. Every noir novelist has the heart and soul of a poet maudit, a poet of the streets, of the gutter. As the Montana poet Richard Hugo once wrote, "You might come here Sunday on a whim, say your life broke down, the last good kiss you had was years ago. You walk these streets laid out by the insane, past hotels that didn't last, bars that did, the tortured try of local drivers to accelerate their lives. Only churches are kept up. The jail turned 70 this year. The only prisoner is always in, not knowing what he's done." From this poem, the legendary American crime writer James Crumley drew the title of his most famous work, The Last Good Kiss. James Crumley was born in Three Rivers, Texas, the son of an oil rigger. He is the author of 11 books. Mr. Crumley was the crown prince of American blue-collar, working-class literary culture. He belonged to the people who built the highways, the schools, and the hospitals in our land. He was a child of the Depression who came of age during the Vietnam War. Mr. Crumley wrote of a world where nothing was guaranteed except the sun and the moon, the mountains, the earth, and the highway, and the never-ending treachery of women and men. He drew his text from the psychogeography of our country, from its very soil, from the heartland, like cold, clean water extracted from a dark, pristine well. He painted the map of our nation as it is passing from one century into the next. As he himself said in the opening sentence of The Last Good Kiss, "When I finally caught up with Abraham Traherne, he was drinking beer with an alcoholic bulldog named Fireball Roberts in a ramshackle joint just outside of Sonoma, California, drinking the heart right out of a fine spring afternoon." Ladies and gentlemen, James Crumley has left the house. Amen.